Managing money as a couple can be a struggle, but we're gonna make it easy.
Hey guys, welcome to the Cashflow Talk. Thank you for joining us. If you like what you're hearing, subscribe below, comment below, let us know if you guys have any questions. So today we want to talk about how do we manage money as a couple. And the first thing that I want to suggest you, if you have a couple, if you're in a relationship, obviously, talk with your wife, talk with your spouse, because everything starts with great communication. Being on the same page, having the same goals, having the same vision is key for understanding and managing money together.
Yeah, so many people ask us continuously, how do you guys manage to work together, live together, do everything together? I mean, we work from home and that's a privilege, but we see each other 24 hours a day. Like, we're together all day long. And so questions arise all the time. How do you guys work together? How do you guys do to manage your money together? And I think the key answer to that is to be very clear on what each other's purposes are and what others goals are. If I am clear to him of what is it that I am looking for or what are my goals, and he's clear to me, we can both manage our money and our finances and our investments in a way where it's beneficial to both of us. Remember, you guys are a team. It's all about thinking in a team perspective versus thinking as a solo person.
Exactly. And having the same priorities, or not the same priorities, but having the priorities lined up. For example, in our personal life, one of my priorities was to do the living room, but one of her priorities was to redo the our master bedroom. And sometimes I win, sometimes I don't, but that's fine. You know, it's not a battle. So we chose to do the living room first. Sorry, the master bedroom first. Yeah. And then next, we're going to do the living room because that's what I wanted to do next. So it's about compromising. It's about committing to each other, and it's about communication. But let's talk about money wise. So money comes in. How do we manage money? How are you supposed to manage money properly? So each family member, mom and dad, or wife and husband, they both have a job or they have a business. The proper way to do it is to have a jar system. And the jar system, or a piggyback system, we talk about it in other YouTube videos. So make sure you check those out, how we split money. But the way we do it with couples is each party is going to, we're going to put all the money into one main account where we distribute all the necessities, all the rent, payment, mortgage, electricity, all these things. But then we take out an equal amount for her personal account and one for my personal account. And I don't ask her what she does with that money, and she doesn't ask me what I do with that money. Because that's the key about this, is we have to be able to live separately as well and enjoy each other on our own time as well.
Yeah, you've got to respect each other's choices. Maybe for me, it's really important to do my hair and my nails and go to the salon, have a massage, and have a great day at the spa. And for him, it might be awesome to buy new golf sticks. Call that. Or spend the whole day at the golf course, and that's how he wants to enjoy that money. So make sure you each respect each other's wishes with their money. And of course, if you guys have seen our other videos with managing money, you will see that we have a fund specifically for our financial freedom account, which is our investments. So it's not like I'm gonna go out there, grab money and just waste it or spend it in things that don't matter. They matter because they're important to me, but I also know there is a fund specifically taken only for our investments, and that's the fund that I will not touch to do my nails or do my hair. I will make sure that we do investments together from that fund.
Exactly. And another thing is understanding what role you have as a couple, because it's important as well. You know, she has many roles in the family that she leads, and I have many roles in the family that I lead. And that's one of the things that we have to discuss about. Which one of you is going to manage the funds? Who's going to pay more attention to the money management and the investment side of it? There's always one of the couples, one of the people in the couple one of the partners that is going to be more into managing the bank and checking the money daily and checking the bank statements and checking online where's this money coming from and going to. I am that person. I'm the person that is always checking the mail, opening the mail, and making sure that everything is lined up every single day. She's more, she has other roles in the family, taking care of the baby and all these little things that are very important, but she's not every day checking the bank statement. She checks her bank account that I don't ask questions on what she's spending the money on, but she doesn't ask me the questions either. And when we're going at an investment together, obviously it's our fund, it's our money, and we use it together properly. You know, we have great communication, so we talk about it and then we move forward into investments or other expenses that we may want to do.
Yes, but it's very important. Even though the other person might have not a leading role with the money, they always know and are aware of what the expenses are, what kind of payments are being done in the household, what kind of necessities are being paid for, and what's the bills in the household. It's very important for both parties to be involved in the finances of the family, because there's nothing worse than coming with surprises that one of the parties didn't know, and then that's where discussion and untrust comes from, right? Well, you don't trust the other person because there's all these surprises, but you were never really into looking at the finances. So make sure that you don't commit this mistake, and everybody involved in those finances, in those funds, and that income coming in has a knowledge of where that money's going to.
Exactly. If you can only take one thing out of here, I would suggest the key starts with communication, understanding where you are, where you're going to, have the same goals, or even if you have separate goals, understand what the other person's goal is, and have goals as an individual and have goals as a family, as a couple. You know, it's different if I want to go and play golf 2 or 3 times a week than if we want to go to a family trip together as a family. If we want to have certain amount of properties or income coming in, or if we want to save X amount of money for a future expense or a future purchase that we want to do, just have separate individual goals, but also have goals as a couple, as a family. Because that's the key. And like Michelle said, you need both inputs from both sides. All right. It's all for the well-being of the family. It's all for the future of the family. And again, if you haven't seen the videos about money management, we have 4 or 5 videos about the jar system. We call them the piggy banks. And it's a money management system that we teach people how to manage money properly. Because believe it or not, many people are living the day by day and getting by. It really sucks. It really sucks getting by every day and not having any money to invest, to educate yourself, to learn. And that's it. I just wanted to, why don't you share the Street Smart Club with them? Because it's something that I believe that if you're interested in that, and if you've seen all these entire video until the end, I think it's something that you may be interested in.
Yeah, so the Street Smart Club is all about elevating your financial security and elevating your financial knowledge, because there is a lot of talk out there about sales and men and creating more cash flow and attracting the right client and talking to your client and being a magnet through social media. And yes, the Street Smart Club is a platform where you learn all of these areas. But what really sets us apart is that we deconstruct the system of financial security. We make sure that you understand how to manage your money, how to handle every single penny that comes into your pocket, so that you not only have money to invest and put back into your business, but you pay yourself first. You have money available to travel. You have money available to help other people and to really live life as you design from the core of your dreams. That is our passion. That is our mission. And so the Street Smart Club is a club of entrepreneurs who are not willing to play average anymore. They want to elevate their business, take it to the next level, and learn about sales and learn about attracting your clients. Yes. But also learn about that financial literacy that is lacking out there in the traditional education and any other education as well. And so Camilo and I bring that component, and the website to join our membership club, it's a monthly membership club, is www.streetsmartclub.com.
Absolutely, guys. It's an awesome community. And again, it's entrepreneurs that we get together as a mastermind. We talk about a specific topic that has to do with sales, marketing. So we help you generate more money with whatever you're doing. generate more cash flow, generate more income, manage it so then you can start investing either in real estate, which is our arena, or anything else that you want to do. But it's increasing your income, learning how to manage it so you can start investing it, and ultimately look out for the financial freedom. Guys, check it out, streetsmartclub.com. And if you like this video, please comment below, share it, like it, guys. Please help us out. Subscribe below and let us know how we're doing. And we'll see you in the next video.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.